We'll see in a second, because it looks like the dream is dead now, because as you lot probably just saw, I hope Google Translate tells me something different. But, and again, I urge caution, you know, it's Arsenal stops discussions for Aouar. Obviously, you heard that all the time with United and Sancho. United are walking away. They're looking at Coleman. They're doing this. So I think them doing that and us doing what we're doing are two different things. But there's a lot of poker between all clubs and whatnot, people. But if we accept this at face value, Arsenal stops discussions for Aouar after having transmitted a transfer offer for Hossam Aouar. Arsenal do not wish to go beyond the proposed amount. The Gunners are in the process of withdrawing from the case. I mean, what's going on here? By drawing the very first offer of the summer for Hossam Aouar, Arsenal tried a blow an amount. Again, Google Translate. Tried to blow an amount, I guess, less than 20 million euros, when Lyon's hopes between 20 and 25 million euros minimum. For more than a week, discussions have continued and the two clubs are trying to see if a common ground is possible. So again, they're still, what does that tell you? Regardless of the sensationalized headline, and that's probably gonna, when I cut this up, that's gonna be the title of the next vid. The teams are still talking. You've got to be prepared to walk away, I guess. If you've got an offer and then they're saying one thing, it's an issue. I'm not criticizing Ben White, but you know, if you can find 50 million on Ben White and 20 million on Ramsdale, you can find 25 million for Hossam Aouar, because he's going to pay for himself. He's going to make your team stronger. Certain man that are in control with transfers were midfielders, and the midfield hasn't been patterned. You'll see a better Partey. He would have resale value, but signed for 25, you might be able to sell him for 50 if you do your job. He's the same age as Ben White as well. I don't know, man. And allegedly, if you wanted him for 2 years, who better than to quote unquote potentially over prepare for than someone that you've clearly wanted for 2 years and whatnot, and probably bidded higher last year? Obviously, there might be some bread might not be available. I don't know what's going on. But anyways, according to our file, however, Arsenal have indicated that it would stop there in the Aouar file. The Gunners won't come up with more than their first offer. It is not impossible that the English competition on file motivated the London leaders to say stop. Indeed, as revealed by Le Ten Sport, Spurs, Liverpool and Man United are also in the game. Spurs are expected to submit a bid shortly. Liverpool are thinking of Aouar to take over Wijnaldum, two completely different players. And obviously, this article's gone on to leverage the fact that Pogba may or may not be going. And United fans, if you're listening, you're probably going to get linked with hella midfielders if you're not already. You know, I think the only midfielder I ain't seen them link with is Pjanic, but yeah, man, what a summer, you know, what a summer. That one there seems locked off already. What a madness. But it is what it is in that regards. Make sure you're hitting the like button. Arsenal and Lyon end talks for... Keep spelling my man's name wrong. But boy. And I mean, as much as I like Aouar, he's not the only footballer in the world. So again, if you lock off talks with him, I'm only seeing it at face value. You've wanted a man for 2 years. If you don't want him, I mean, if you can't get him, just make sure there's a plan B, plan C, plan D. That, you know, like I said, is there an next 2-3 other players that might not all be playing for Lyon and stuff, but they're of the same profile. They play in that eight role, 8.5. They're 23 years of age. You know, statistically, whatever our strengths and weaknesses are, they're more or less the same with that. Crucially, are they a good partner for Partey or Lokonga long-term? Do they tie into what we're doing? Because again, you know, as long as you've got other targets, it is what it is. But suddenly, if you miss out on Aouar, you miss out on a different player, but Buendia, you know, the bet to bring in Odegaard, we're going to get into it, but may or may not bang, and looks like it hasn't banged. You know, that's free signings. You know, you turned away from Szoboszlai towards the end of last year. Better just have a plan. Like I said, I'm prepared to sit on my hands and not go mad and whatnot and carry on a certain sort of way. But there'll be serious question marks come whenever the window closes, end of August, beginning of September. Because like I said, there needs to be plan Bs. Boy, you don't get that midfield right, you can kiss goodbye to forget Champions League and Europa League and them things. Even though I know the club are getting into bed and it's quite a cozy relationship between the managerial staff, those just above him and the owner of this club, but it could get real long by Christmas, before Christmas. Because at best, the current options, with the exception of Partey and shout out to Smith Rowe, just organic centre mids, they're not good enough. Because like, they're not bad players, but they're not good enough. And at best, you're just going to see flavour of the month. You're going to see flavour of the month stuff, purple patches. There's going to be a month, 3 weeks, whatever, where they're unstoppable. I'm not saying to attack people, but we've been through this already. You know, there's times El Nene looks sick. You know, when we played Man United and we beat them. He had a decent season, to be fair, but he looks sick. You know how us fans get. Our fans, they... Do you know the wickedest thing, yeah? The club need to be ruthless, but our fans are not as ruthless as they claim, you know. They will say get this, they only want the good players out, funny enough. They will say get this guy, that guy out, but certain fans, the minute these guys play well for five games, and it's nothing wrong with it, I'm just saying it, oh, nah, they're different, because that's what Arsenal players are doing. And then they will go through mad form, and I'm just painting a picture. I've got time for him. Bellerin, you know, Xhaka's a bit better than people give him credit for, but a lot of it is overstated. If you get someone who can do what he does to a better degree, it's irrelevant. To 5-10 games, these guys look good. 5 games, they look shaky. We keep going down these ways and these roads. And, you know, when you've got one player like that, I'm prepared to gamble. When you got a whole squad like that, you're gambling wrong, innit? You're not enjoying gambling. You're gambling because you can't come out. You can't move away from the roulette machine. It's a bit mad. So as long as there's other targets, it is what it is. I would love Hossam Aouar, but he's not the only guy in the world. As I always say for all clubs, if it's not Lionel Messi, you know, if it's not Lionel Messi, CR7 or Deludi Gunard, bro, you can get other players out there. Like, them three there, they're not really, you can't really get them. You can't replicate what they got. You need to move for them early, or if you've got the money to spend on them, then you do it. But if not, boy, it is what it is. You know, it is what it is in that regard. You look like that shameless one, innit? I said it effortlessly. I stopped looking because I was going to start laughing. But shout out to everyone locked in. Please make sure you're hitting the like button, people. Please make sure you're setting reminders of the next watch along. I've dropped the link. Right, big up S. Link's been dropped there as well. And as you lot can see, it's watch along business tomorrow.